Hey, welcome back to another video. This time I want to dissect one of my tunes or one of my sketches I recently made, in fact yesterday. And I used some instruments and I try not to build something inside Bitwig, more like I try to rely on some presets I made, some sounds I made, and just use Bitwig as a canvas and yeah, paint some tracks and automations. And the reason for that is that I see sometimes people struggle with creating new tracks or new songs, and the reason for that is maybe that they go into Bitwig and have a lot of possibilities, in fact thousands of possibilities, and yeah, they go into certain instruments or into the grid, and then they lose control over the whole situation and just come out 3 hours later with some random noise or something like that. And when I try to create some tracks, like in this case here, I'm more like Bob Ross. I have my colors, I have my brushes, and then I go in and boldly paint all over the canvas and don't care for anything. So I don't try to create instruments, I don't go into detail with modulators, I just use them to practically get something done or out of my head, basically. So it's more like an practical approach to making music. So for instance, when we have this piano here and I have some automation painted in here, I can do that with a modulator, yeah, below in maybe with an ADSR, and use a long attack time or something like this. But it's not practical to use it that way. It's much easier to just open here the lanes and paint it in. And I'm not very precise with it. I'm just painting, yeah, and have fun. So as you can see here, down here, I have an arpeggiator with a synth, and I just painted in some stuff here, just to have something going on, to make it more alive, and yeah, make it feel more natural. And I'm using here the filter envelope depth to, yeah, change basically the cutoff, and yeah, it works most of the times. And when I'm done with this stage, as you can see, I have all tracks here in notes or in MIDI. I have all the note informations, all the automation informations available, and I can change it anytime. But when I'm done and I say, oh, well, this sounds okay, then I'm going to the bouncing stage where I bounce everything down to audio, and then is everything integrated into the wave and the complexity goes away. And most of the times I am going then to disable the tracks to have it available in a later stage, but I never going back, to be honest. I am staying with the wave files, and that's how I approach it, basically. And this is Treft here, a sketch I've done, and I'm going to probably save it to disk and open it 2 months later or weeks later and try to add some stuff and change some stuff, and that's it. But sometimes, like yesterday, I had to get something out of my head into the sequencer, and that's where when I'm in that mode, I don't care for modulators or complex modulations, modulator chains or something like that, or I don't go into the grid. I just paint in automations and rely on old presets. some instrumental percussions here. These vocals are by me, with a bit of auto-tune. So yeah, that's the sketch. And for the piano here, I use the piano book preset, more or less. And these piano book presets are made from this piano book project here, which are basically users on the internet that have pianos at home and they try to sample different pianos. Not so extremely good sampled, it's just two layers of velocity, as you can say here, see here, and yeah, some parts of the octaves, but for this track here I found it's enough, it sounds good enough to me, and I just added a bit of cool force to correct some frequencies and bring in some bass with the boost here, and I used an EOS 2 reverb, and I used the grain space here to get some kind of sparkly texture on top. That sounds very nice. Very nice. So it's just mixed in a little bit. And I have the tape machine here, which is a preset by me. And you can download this in the factory presets, Bitwig 3.0. And yeah, as you can see here, I rely on some presets I already made. It's not what I made exactly for this project here. That would take too long. And I just put in here a piano I had and added some VSTs I had and the preset I already made beforehand. And yeah. That's also the case here with the bass. I use an Reactor Monarch because I think it sounds pretty great. I even think it sounds better than the emulations by Arturia. And yeah, use an arpeggiator here with the polysynth and also a Modnetic VST, which I really like. It's by Serial Machines. It's not expensive and it sounds great. So it's a nice little mixture of Bitwig presets, modulations, automations, and VSTs, right? So just stuff I really like and think it needs, the track needs at this point. So here I have a voice pad, which is also a preset by me. And you can see I modulated the output here because I made this preset more or less infinite, so there's no no node cut off at some point, so I was lazy and I just used the automation here to fade it in and out. And when I bounce this down the audio, it's not so, I don't care for that, basically. So I bounce this down the wave and I have a nice fade in and a fade out at the end here, so it's perfect. And the vox here is, this is sung in by me. And I used the M Auto Pitch here by Melder, which is a free plugin. And you can use it like autotune, basically. You have, I used here the minor and the A, so I'm selecting all the A minor keys basically, and this plugin tries to correct all these my wrongly sung notes into right notes. And also I use the format shift here to make it so it sounds more like a woman that's singing. And I used a bit of width here, which makes kind of different frequency shifts, I think, in the left and the right channel, so it sounds a bit more wider. Yeah, this is how it sounds. Also this halftime plugin here, which just slows down the audio 2 times, and I mixed in the original signal, which also sounds pretty great. Okay, then we have the percussions here, which is Hans Zimmer percussions and a contact patch, just played in with my keyboard. I first try to hammer in this rhythm here with just one finger. And after that, I correct basically all the, some notes I corrected, some are just off the grid, so it's not so straight on the grid. And I added some additional hits here to accentuate basically some of the bars and small fill in. As you can see, also a lot of changes here on the velocity. Some of the velocity values are straight played in and I don't change it afterwards, so it's more natural. And these fill in here, I just painted in basically with the pen tool, so I have a straight ramp going up. And yeah, that's it for the percussions basically. And here at the end, I used a different pattern, a slightly different pattern, a shorter pattern, so it's more, more pumping. Also some kind of snare. So that's the groove at the end. And then I have also a second layer of percussions here at the end, just drive it even more to the dance floor. And also I use the panning here slightly to the right one of the tracks, and the other one is slightly to the left, so it's not dead center, right? So it's when you are sitting basically in front of an ensemble, nothing is exactly straight in the center. So you have some percussions on the left and some string ensembles on the right and the trumpets maybe in the middle or something like that. So I'm trying to pan all these instruments to different sides. And then we have the horns here, and you can see there is a lot of modulation here, which is the mod wheel. And I'm usually trying to play this also in with my keyboard. And yeah, some of the notes are corrected because they are not exactly on the grid, and some of them are just off the grid. and the mod wheel is completely recorded. There's nothing changed here by me with the mouse. It's just so how I moved my mod wheel basically and recorded that. And yeah, then you can duplicate it, as you can see here. This is basically recorded, then duplicated to this. And you also duplicate the modulation with this clip. So that's why it looks so strange here. Also, the Gymbassy is also recorded, and some notes are corrected. Yeah, and it's much easier that way. And if you look here at the first example at my piano, this main melody basically, I think I just recorded this bit here, this one. And I used my fingers on my keyboard to try to find some keys I like that maybe work. And then I try to come up with the pattern, which note I press at which time, right? And sometimes I record just longer patterns where I accidentally hit different notes. And then I cut this note clip basically up until it loops nice to my ears. And yeah, I added the bass line here, a bass note, as you can see. So it sounds like it's changing all the time, basically. But in real life, it's basically just this small pattern which I recorded with my keyboard in my hands, because I can't play keyboard. But this is something I can do. And you also get a lot of additional informations into the track, like velocity and the mod wheel, for instance. And I also used here the cutoff, which I used the automation for, just to have it, the piano at the start, a bit smoother, and then it opens up here at the end, right? So it's a small automation. Okay. Then at the end here, we have some strings. And you can see there is a straight single note here, and I used basically inside contact, I used here the ostinatum, which is more like an arpeggiator. And you can see I can define here some notes which should be played. And I used the multi-note, which just puts out a minor chord, goes straight into the diatonic transposer, which gives me an A minor chord. And then here I used the ostinatum to play an arpeggio. Basically, you can see I can change here the notes. That's the root note, then the third note, and the second note. And I just plain use the tool here to fade it a bit in. And the horns. As you can see, I'm straight all on the white keys here. I already made a tutorial about how you can play with the piano if you are absolutely noob, like me. And I'm staying straight on the white keys here all the time. So it's pretty noobish. But it sounds okay to my ears, at least. And I'm happy with it. So yeah, the plan is maybe to bring in some additional synthesizers to give the track more character, some melodies, maybe a quiet part, or make it more epic in some areas. But for now, that's a pretty nice sketch. And when I save this and open it later in some weeks or months up, I have something to start with. And the last step, basically what I do now, is to bounce everything down to audio. Sometimes you deinstall some or uninstall some VSTs or some libraries, and then you can open up the project. Or as you can see here, I have a lot of contact libraries that are really, really big. And it takes some time when you open up the project, right? And therefore, I'm bouncing everything down to audio, and then it's safe, and I can work with it later in this year. This piano here at the start, which is called Piano Book Raw, is available in my GitHub repository, which is called Bitwig Piano Book. And I try to convert all the samples or are the pianos from this website here, which is called pianopoc.co.uk, and people are there trying to sample their pianos at home and save them as contact patches, and I convert this to Bitwig sampler patches, basically. And so it's not my single effort, it's just an my service basically to convert this to Bitwig. And yeah, I used this here, and also some of the patches I used here, for instance, this voice pad is also available in my my repo, Polarity Music Tools repo, as you can see here at the bottom, voice pad 1, voice pad 1, voice pad 2 is available in my GitHub. Okay, that's it. So I wanted to dissect this tune here and just show that you don't need always to make complicated modulators, complicated instruments, or chain up thousands of instruments. If you want to do something, just go in, use it as a canvas, take your colors, take your presets, take your samples, and just paint something. Save it and then open it up later on and continue. And at some point at the weekend, when you're not feeling it to create a track or more in like an experimental phase, then you go to Bitwig and just create presets that you can use when you are in the mood of making a track. It's very handy to just track in some very complex sounds or pads, like this voice pad here I created with a Polygrid. Just to have this kind of stuff ready when you need it. And if you look at it, all stuff that's in this track here is basically pre-made. There's nothing I created on the fly, besides maybe this vocals here I just sung in with my voice and the notes I played. Yeah, that's maybe something to consider when you try to make a track. And before I close down this video, I have three small tips for you. And these tips are not ads, so it's just something I used for myself. I bought it and I want to give this out. I don't get money for this to advertise this, okay? So the first tip is Loom 2, I recently bought. It's $14. Or 12 euros, which is pretty cheap. It's an additive synth, and maybe I do some tutorials in the future for this one, because I really like the synth. And yeah, when you buy it, you also get, just at the moment, this Iris 2 VST for free, which is also a pretty interesting synth. And for free, and this one for 12 euros, it's pretty much a no-brainer. And you can see you can make some spectral operations here, and you can maybe use it to extract vocals from, yeah, from songs or something like this. So it's nothing you can do in Bitwig at the moment. Yeah, it ends at 31st of August 2019, so yeah, you have some time to think about it. And also The sample packs from Intimate Noise are currently at 14%. And I already made a tutorial where I used the free sample pack by Intimate Noise and made a track out of it. And as you just saw in this tutorial, I used a lot of pre-made sounds, presets, samples, different sources, right? And it's always more interesting when you have different sources in your project, not just only synths or only samples, something like this. So it's very important to have some nice, interesting samples on your hard disk. And these packs are really, pretty interesting. It's not just your generic 808 sound sample pack. And it's currently at 14%. So also a no-brainer. Yeah, that's it for this video. Thanks for watching, and I hope to see you soon in the next one. And also a big thank you to all my Patreons. And I already uploaded a track that is free to download for all the Patreons. So enjoy that. And yeah, until next time, see you and bye.